हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ अंसारी साफिया फ्रॉम फिजिक्स डिपार्टमेंट JAT आर्ट्स साइंस एंड कॉमर्स कॉलेज फॉर वीमेन मालेगांव। नाउ दिस प्रेजेंटेशन इज फॉर क्लास SOIBSC फिजिक्स पेपर फर्स्ट सेक्शन फर्स्ट। नाउ द टाइटल इज ग्रेडियंट ऑफ ए स्केलर। नाउ डियर स्टूडेंट, we know vector differential operator denoted by del, also called nebula. Now in vector analysis there are three fundamental operations with del which are useful in physics. Now first one is del phi, where phi is a scalar quantity and del phi is known as gradient of a scalar. Now del dot v, that is divergence of v, and third operation del cross v, that is curl of vector v. Now today we have to study gradient of scalar and its physical significance. Now let phi is a function of x, y, z, and it is also a function of position vector r, where r is equal to ix plus jy plus kz. Now the total differential of phi due to infinitesimal increments dx, dy, dz is d phi is equal to curly phi by curly x dx plus curly phi by curly y dy plus curly phi by curly z dz. Now this equation can be written as d phi is equal to I curly phi by curly x plus j curly phi by curly y plus k curly phi by curly z dot I dx plus j dy plus k dz, where first bracket is gradient phi and the second bracket I dx plus j dy plus k dz is dr. Therefore d phi is equal to del phi dot dr. Now del phi is equal to I curly phi by curly x plus j curly phi by curly y plus k curly phi by curly z. Now here note that phi del is not equal to del phi. Now we have to study its physical significance. Now figure shows two surfaces S1 and S2 which are very close to each other. Now the scalar function has value phi for S1. Now as we go from S1 to S2, then the scalar value changes, phi plus d phi. So the scalar value for the surface S2 is phi plus d phi. Now suppose that O is origin and P and Q, these are two points on the surfaces S1 and S2. Now the total differential of phi is expressed by d phi is equal to curly phi by curly x dx plus curly phi by curly y dy plus curly phi by curly z dz. In figure, O is origin, P and Q, these are two points on the level surfaces S1 and S2. Now the position vector of the point P from the origin O is OP, that is vector R, and the position vector of the point Q from the origin O is R plus dr, which is equal to vector OQ. So by the law of triangle of vector addition, we get PQ is equal to dr, which is equal to idx plus jdy plus kdz. Therefore, above equation this equation first can be written as d phi is equal to I curly phi by curly x plus j curly phi by curly y plus k curly phi by curly z dot I dx plus j dy plus k dz. Now the first bracket is gradient phi dot second bracket is dr. Now both are vector quantities, therefore it is equal to magnitude of del phi, magnitude of dr and cosine of angle between them. Now in figure, n is unit vector normal to the level surface S1. Now in figure, n is a unit vector normal to the level surface S1 at the point P. Now this unit vector is in the direction of increasing phi. If theta is angle between PQ and n, then this equation can be written as d phi is equal to del phi dr cos theta. Therefore, from this equation, we can write d phi by dr is equal to del phi into cos theta. Here, d phi by dr represents the space rate of change of phi with distance. Now, if theta is equal to 0, then cos 0 is equal to 1. Therefore, above equation becomes d phi by dr, which will be maximum when theta is equal to 0 and which is equal to del phi. That means the magnitude of del phi is the maximum space rate of change of phi at a point, and it is directed along the normal to the level surface through the point.